Texting and drinking is never a good idea. We've all done it, and we've all regretted it. The drunken texts you forgot you sent. Prospectors collected them in inTEXTicated on Rock 107.
From the 910, Memphis, Tennessee. Co-worker just walked in, 30 minutes late, reeking of weed and clutching a handful of scratch-off tickets. Also, there's still a stripper pole in my office. Hope you're having a good day. From the 703, Arlington, Virginia, bailing my boss out of jail is a great way to spend Memorial Day.
You hit send, and we hit the floor laughing. inTEXTicated on Rock 107.
Bridgeport, Connecticut, area code 203. I think Memorial Day also marks the beginning of bikini profile pic season. Area code 615, Nashville, Tennessee. I love Memorial Day. It's drinking in the name of patriotism. God bless America.
Proof that booze and cell phones don't mix. inTEXTicated on Rock 107.
From Germantown, Maryland, area code 301. Dude, it's Memorial Day. Not getting wasted equals you're a terrorist. And from the 907, Anchorage, Alaska. Memorial Day weekend is going to be amazeballs, jungle juice, drunk guys, and being stimulated by the vibrations of a four-wheeler. I mean, there's no way that can go wrong.
Hey, we found him in your telephone. inTEXTicated on Rock 107. Broken. Tune in tomorrow for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
For another episode of 1 Minute Inside a Woman's Head.
Ah, it's great to be back at the lake for Memorial Day. And all the regulars are back. Guy with a reptile on his shoulder and a story to tell you about it. Woman who thinks she still rocks a bikini but is somehow unaware of the flab spillage. Oh, who am I kidding? I'm totally jealous of her confidence. Oh, there's the guy with the out-of-control barking dog that I'm convinced never got all its shots, if any. And the woman with tattoos of her children's faces. I think they're smiling? So many ways to honor your kids without immortalizing them on your thigh. And then there's me, chalky white, long shorts, sun hat that just blew away, and I dropped my car keys somewhere. Where's the guy with the metal detector when you need him?
And that was another episode of 1 Minute Inside a Woman's Head.
And now it's time for another episode of A Few Seconds Inside a Man's Head.
Oh, man, are those big. Uh-oh, did I just say that out loud?
And that was another episode of A Few Seconds Inside a Man's Head.
Life's pretty tough right now. There's plenty of bad news, but it's not all bad. It's time for the brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
Two high school kids in Indianapolis met after they were both diagnosed with bone cancer and just went to the prom together. The best news is she finished her last round of chemo in October, and he's now been in remission for 2 years.
Thanks. We needed that. The brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
I don't want to overreact here, but society as you and I know it is about to end. Good morning, I'm Rock 107's Prospector. Have you gotten your scolding from Netflix yet? If not, brace yourself, because they started rolling out their crackdown on password sharing in the United States yesterday. From here on out, anyone using your account better live with you, because they're going to charge you another $7.99 for anyone living outside your own home to use your account. They decided it's time to put their foot down and remind us that our Netflix account is for us and the people we live with, our household. Oh, thanks, Netflix. Thanks for clarifying the definition of a household. I didn't know my Aunt Sue and her 50 cats don't count as part of my household. Now, they've been working on this crackdown for over a year. I mean, talk about dedication. I mean, if Netflix put half that effort into solving buffering issues as they did into stopping password sharing, we'd all be living in a utopia of uninterrupted streaming bliss. Now, premium subscribers can add up to 2 non-household members, while standard plan subscribers can only add 1. Primary account holders will have to set a household location on their devices, though you'll still be able to use your account when you travel. So, do I share passwords for any of my streaming platforms? Let's just say if password sharing was an Olympic sport, I'd be like Usain Bolt, all right? I've been going for the gold. I'm passing around logins like a digital Robin Hood. And don't bank on customer outrage making this all go away. They've already been doing it in other countries, and they've seen an increase in paid memberships in most regions. All of this leads me to something you didn't ask for, you don't want, but I'm giving it to you anyway. It's another Prospector poorly sung parody to the tune of Tom Petty's Breakdown. It's Crackdown on Rock 107. Hey, Netflix, they don't love it. Yeah, Netflix hates being in this boat. They got afraid of you sharing your password, honey. They got a way that you won't. There is no sense in pretending. Your ISP gives you away. Now they will charge you a fee for your Bluetooth. They said we all have to pay. Baby, crack down. Netflix wants more money. Crack down, honey. Pay them through the nose. Crack down. I'm streaming here, can't you see? Crack down, it's not all right. I know, I can't say it. I'm still going to keep doing it.
Ignoramus, you know, a dullard, simpleton, or a clot, nitwit, dipstick, pea brain, mouth breather, or cretin.
It's now time to announce the winner of Prospector's Jam Bag of the Day, as decided by you at rock107.com.
Here are the nominees. Nominee number one.
If you're going to eat the last Hot Pocket, you better make sure everyone's cool with it first, because Hot Pocket rage is real. A 64-year-old man in Kentucky named Clifton Williams freaked out on his roommate last weekend after noticing he'd eaten the last Hot Pocket. Clifton was furious. He threw some kind of tiles at the roommate, and when the guy tried to get away, that's when Clifton got his gun and shot the guy in the butt. The roommate did manage to run off, get help, and was hospitalized. He'll be okay, but being shot over a Hot Pocket was still a pain in the butt. I mean, on top of that, he probably had a burnt tongue from the Hot Pocket too, right? Clifton was arrested for assault.
Nominee number two.
A 37-year-old landlord in Minnesota named Travis Carlson deliberately set his apartment on fire last Thursday while blasting the 33-year-old Billy Joel song, We Didn't Start the Fire. Travis drilled holes in his truck's gas tank, put the gas into cans, then carried them back and forth up to his apartment. His downstairs tenant heard him smashing glass and breaking things for about 20 minutes. Then he knocked on that tenant's door and told him, the house is on fire. When firefighters arrived, they found the apartment on fire with We Didn't Start the Fire blaring from the unit. I think they should have responded by playing Alanis Morissette's song Ironic, but they didn't. Travis could face up to 20 years in prison. It's unclear why he did it, or if he tried to argue that it was always burning since the world's been turning.
And the winner is...
the landlord, who started an apartment building on fire while blaring the song We Didn't Start the Fire. I guess you love irony, but I know you're the Yam Bag of the Day, and we'll move on to Friday's Yam Bag of the Week competition. Keep it here, weekday mornings, for your chance to hear the nominees for Prospector's Yam Bag of the Day on Rock 107.
Cuts Podcast. Be sure to catch us live weekdays from 5:30 to 10 a.m. on Rock 107 or online at rock107.com or the Rock 107 app, a free download for your Android or iPhone. Subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher Radio, or wherever you get your podcasts so you never miss Prospector's Prime Cuts.